Anything else on jigs? Okay.
Real quick, on the plastic, do they make 10X crappie plastic? Like they do the stretchable?
I haven't seen any in a long time. I saw some several years ago, and then they just kind of faded out.
What about the new Gulp product? Do they wear good?
Gulp products are not as durable. I mean, they're good products, but they won't last as long.
They slime on your hands and stuff?
A little bit. I hadn't used them enough to really know. Okay, I'm going to talk, now this is the weird stuff. Now you guys just bear with me on this, because this is, when I talk about the fact that I like to experiment, I'm going to show you some of the experimentation that I've done. And most of this, I promise you, is just baloney, but you may be able to pick up something that you actually like in here. And by the way, you know, y'all seen, a lot of y'all have seen Paul and Jerry's wintertime fishing. This is a Captain Coleman rig. The first video that y'all made, what, 4, 5, 6 years ago? In that video, I used to have a copy of it. In that video, he showed how they tied these things up for storage. And in case y'all can't see that, this is that's the bottom hook. This is the reverse. Just twist that thing around and hook it in that eye right there. That way, when you get ready to take that thing apart, you can pull that off. Spin that thing loose right there. There's the bottom hook. Top hook is hooked right here. If I can get this little spin out of it that I put in there. Yeah. And then you just undo that top one, and you're ready to go. Okay. Yeah. You can get them from Paul or Jerry directly, or you can get it from my website, either one. All right. Now, let me get this thing put together.
Watch it, don't break it.
Yeah, it's a Wally Marshall. We got to be careful with it. All right, you're going to be the rod holder, George. Can you handle that?
Yeah. All right, I'm already called down.
Yeah. Yeah, this is something George ought to be comfortable with. Dang it. All right. Okay. Okay, that's the Captain Coleman rig. Three-way swivel up here. Top hook. Half-ounce weight on the bottom. With that bottom hook down there on the bottom. If y'all want to, if you want to get a closer look at this after we're done, feel free to look at it. Paul's video goes into a lot of detail on this. Now, here's where I change up some things, because obviously I got to do things different. I love the braided line on spider rigging, any kind of trolling setups. The reason I do is because of the sensitivity. Monofilament, because of the stretch, isn't quite as sensitive. I love the braid on there. I hate tying knots on braid. I shouldn't bite monofilament with my teeth, but I do. But I can't do that with braid, and I got to get the scissors out and kind of saw and cut and get all that done. So what I've done, you can get these at Bass Pro Shops. That's those little fast lock snaps. That's all I've got to do. If I break a hook, I just unsnap that, throw this over in the corner of the boat. In Jerry's video, he shows how to make these things up beforehand and store them on a pool needle. I just roll one out, hook it back on there, close that little snap, and I'm ready to go fishing again. Okay? Very simple, very quick, easy way to change out for new baits when you break out, and a good way to change baits if you like to do different types of fishing. All right, let me pull this off, and I'll set this down for a minute. This is something that I've been piddling around with and experimenting with, and I like it for the most part, but it's a little more complicated, and I'm going to try and really work on a lot of this spring. You've probably seen guys talk about pushing jigs or spider rigging jigs. What I've done, I've tied these things. These are little pipe insulation foam that you can get at Walmart. They're split with the glue strip in the middle. Just pull that strip off and stick them together. and I take a toothpick and run a toothpick in there, and then I go ahead and tie these up in advance. And all this is a little road runner with a single swivel, just a barrel swivel on the front. Okay? That's all it is. Then I've got different kinds of bass weights with the little swivel on the top. This is a 2-ounce weight, which is too much for this pole, but I've got some heavier tight line poles.
Okay.
You sure? All you do with this is take that big heavy swivel, that big weight with the swivel top, put the weight on there first, put that on there second, and close it up, and you're ready to go. Now you get that out in the water, weight's going to go down here, and as you're pushing these things along, about a half a mile to a mile an hour, you got your little road runner running back here behind it. The reason I like this is because I can get absolute 100% perfect depth control. This is a 32nd ounce road runner, and I can put this road runner at 10 and a half feet deep if I want to, but with this weight right up here on the front. And I got barrel weights. That, like I said, that's a 2-ounce weight. I've got them all up to 4 ounces. A lot of guys use 6-ounce, 8-ounce weights on these things. But you can put those things on, and you can get 8 rods. You can get 8 rods with these little setups here. The reason I like this setup is because you can set it all up in advance, and you saw how long it took me to put that together. I mean, you just snap, and you're ready to go fishing. You break one off, it's the same exact thing, just in reverse order.
How much are they?
Oh, they're
$4 will get you 20.
Yeah, they're dirt cheap. They're dirt cheap. I ordered. I'm going to start selling them on Finny Tribe. I ordered 10,000, and I think it cost me. It cost me about 10,000. It cost me about $5,000, I think. Okay, but you get.
Do you own Finny Tribe, or you keep bringing that up?
Yes, I own Finny Tribe. It's shameless plug. Sorry. Okay, and then when you get through with that, you just put it all back together. Okay, and then you can go right back here, and I won't do it here to save time. Put that right back on that toothpick, and wrap it back up, and you've got something now that you can keep these things in order. That's dirt cheap to make. They're small. You can use swimming pool tubes like these because they're a little smaller, and you can get more of them out there. Now I'll leave that alone. I'll use that for jigs. I've got some plain jig heads, 32nd ounce jig heads that I can use plastics on there if I want to push regular jigs out in front of the boat. Regular hooks, little jig heads that I'll put those on.